Okay, this is Atla. He came to us with the name Attila, which makes me think of Attila the Hun, which sounds like a big meanie. Bev actually said, because of his animal control paperwork said Attila, that at the vet clinic they were calling him Attila the Honey, which I think is really cute. But I was looking for something else, and apparently there was a guy named Atla who was a famous musher. So that was a suggestion, but he was, I believe his owner surrendered, and his name was Attila. So when he finds a home, it's going to be one of those. He won't care what you call him at all, as long as you're friendly with him. Anyway, Animal Control contacted me, said he's very scared, owner surrender, male, listed as Samoyed, intact, fine with dogs, coat not too bad. They took him to the vet, and Bev's going to tell you about that, her experience with him, in a minute. We were happy to see that he was heartworm negative, so we had him dropped off there, got the neuter done. Found out he was heartworm negative and got him back in here, and did very well with the surgery and is recovering. He weighs 59 pounds, and somebody said, and we were told just how scared and shy he was, and they said he's quite shy but already coming around with the attention he's getting there. That was per the vet clinic. Bev took him to the vet, so why don't you fill us in on all the great stories you told me, including, you know, the special treatment he got in the car and that sort of thing.
Well, I normally don't let dogs ride in front of the car, but he hopped up in the shotgun seat and he sat there almost the whole time, looking, just looking around, just
aww,
perfect. And then towards the end, he did come over and lay his head on my lap.
Aww.
But he didn't do a single thing to disturb me driving. It was perfect.
Well, he's acting like this now. I mean, that today is Wednesday, so the last time the walkers were here was Saturday. I mean, they do get let out and so forth, but that's not the same as a long walk. And, you know, they kept going on and on about how scared he was. Clearly, I think he remembers Bev for sure. And he let me just come right up and, you know, clean the eye boogers out of his eye and plucked some fur off his front end. And again, in a kennel, it's kind of hard for him to keep clean. Bev said he was very, very clean out of animal control going up to the vet. But yeah, you just never know. So anyway, before anybody meets him, we'll get him a fresh bath. And you said he was just beautiful and fluffy. And mm-hmm. And Bev was talking about, I don't know a lot about this breed, but apparently they have a triple coat. We're going to list him as Sammy, I think. There might be a little something else in there. Maybe, you know, just not a well-bred one. But tell him about, and you may have to speak up just a little, describe the Sammy coat, what you were telling me.
Well, it's a downy down. And then there are short guard hairs that stick up about the length of the downy down. And then there are the long, typical guard hairs.
So it's a triple coat.
So if you put your fingers in like that, you can feel the beginning of the second guard hair.
I see. Well, so he manufactures a lot of fur, I guess. So you definitely want to be somebody that's going to keep up with the grooming and all that. His tail's kind of messy right now. But again, you know, it's a kennel and it's muddy outside. It's hard to keep him real clean. But we'll clean him up for you when you come to take him home. Talking about how scared he was, one of our volunteers that walks on Saturdays wrote and said he was terrified yesterday and hiding in the back den area, which means they have like a little box in the back of their kennel, doghouse area, where they can kind of stay and hide. She said, this morning, the same thing. I tossed some chicken into his kennel and he was too petrified to move and was shaking. So I decided to get into his cage and take the chicken to him. He did eat it, but when I reached for him, he flinched. He appears to have been beaten, and what's even sadder is he submits even when he's scared that he'll be hit. I took a leash and asked him if he wanted to go bye-bye, and he got up and came toward me. So I carefully put the leash on him and took him for a nice walk. He kept turning around to look at me during the walk. He got better and better, and he started letting me and others touch him. We also got him out to play in the play yard, and he met everyone. He's still cautious, but by the time we left, he was up laying down at the front of his cage with his paws hanging out, very relaxed. He's definitely going to be okay. Bev, I have Bev's notes here, but she already explained it to you herself. So I just want to say, I mean, you can tell he's enjoying being petted. He isn't shaking. I mean, we've seen dogs 30 times more scared than this one supposedly is. Now, he just looked around when he heard something, heard a noise in the back room. So he's a little shy, but he's just been very friendly, wants to be petted. Bev wiped his feet off when he came. He had a little mud on his side. Bev cleaned that off of him, and he just stood very quietly and let all that happen. So he does like squeakies. He likes that squeaky, and he wants that squeaky. He's a good boy. Look how gentle he is. Oh, and I think they said they thought he was a couple years old. I will, I'm going to pause a minute, look in his folder, and see if the vet made a guess on his age. I'll be right back. Okay, I'm starting up again. I looked in his paperwork. There was nothing from the vet estimating his age. Beth thinks maybe about four. Teeth are in good shape, not baby wide. We'll say three or four. But he's a good boy. Did you see if he knows Sid or?
We tried.
Okay.
One thing, he wasn't interested at all in the treats.
Okay.
Hey, come here. Do you know how to sit? Come on, sit. Yeah, oh, good boy. You can have the treat even if you don't sit. Now that one he's going to eat.
Oh, he took a nice,
yeah,
well, very gentle, very nice, gentle boy. You're a good boy. Okay, can we have a kiss? Will you give us a kiss and we'll finish your pictures? Here we go. Good boy, good boy. Okay, I don't know if we can get him to do it again, but Bev did get him to sit and got him to shake.
Come here. Give me a paw.
He likes you. You can just tell. Is she your friend? Good boy.
Well, I like him, but I can...
Okay, you said he was kissing the kitties before I got here a little late.
Kissing that kitty, you know, nose in that kitty. He says, I know that one now.
He looks pretty disinterested, doesn't he?
Yeah.
Is he kitty? You are just a sweet boy. Look how good you are. Okay, he doesn't seem interested in the cats at all.
Well, he knows one of them, and then he doesn't have one.
Okay, good boy.
Okay, I tell him.